music class. I'm so excited to share a class with you today. First, we will explore rhythms and musical patterns that are used to create music. Then we will see how we can use tempo to tell a story in music. Lastly, we will see how different instruments and the way we play them can help us to tell a musical story. Are you ready to get started? Let's go! Remember the chant song that we have been learning for a few weeks now? I think we are getting really good at clapping the beat. And I think we understand what the rhythm of the song is. So today, I would like for us to see how the rhythm and the beat go together. Remember that ta receives one beat. Ta. When we say tt, we can fit tt, two of them, into one beat. And we can rest sh for one beat. Ta, tt, sh. Let's try adding this to our chant song. Remember our song? Here's a little ground hog. How many words are on the first beat? Here's a. Here's a. Good, there are two words on one beat, so we should use TT. TT, here's a. Very good. Little, how many parts of the word little are on one beat? Good, two parts of the word little are on one beat. So which notes do we need to use? Ta, TT, or rest? Good, we need to use TT for little. Little. Good. Let's look at ground, hog. How many parts of the word ground hog is on this beat? Just one, ground, ground. So let's use ta, ta, ground. Good. How many parts of the word ground hog are on this beat? Good. The other part of the word ground hog is on the next beat. So which note should we use for the next beat? Right, good job. We should use ta, ta. So our rhythm sounds like this. Maybe you can say the rhythm with me while we snap or clap the beat. Ready? Ti, 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 ta, ta. Very good. You did the first line of our chant song. Great job. Let's look at the second line. The word furry is on the next beat of this line. How many parts of the word furry are there on this beat? Two. Very good. Which note should we use? Right. Good job. We should use TT. Furry. Good. How about the word and? Right, it is just one part. Very good. And. What about brown? Brown. How many parts are on the beat for the word brown? Just one. Very good. So which note should we use? Ta or TT? Good, we can use ta. Very good job. Utah. Okay, let's look at the next heartbeat. Do you see there are no words on this beat? What do you think we should use if there are no words? Right, we can use a rest. Very good. So we can put the rest here. Let's try to say the whole rhythm of this song while we clap the beat. Ready? Can you do it with me? Ti 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 ta ta ti ti ta ta rest. Very good. Excellent. Clapping the beat and saying the rhythm. You're getting so good at this. Very, very good job. You are going to get to do the rest of this song for the next part of this assignment. I know you can do it, and I cannot wait to see how well you do. Good job. Last week, we talked about some rides at the amusement park that move fast and slow, just like the beat in music can be fast like presto and slow like largo. Did you know that we can use tempo in music to help us tell a story? Today, let's sing a story song together. Maybe you have heard of this song before. This song is called Going on a Bear Hunt, and it is an echo song. Do you remember what an echo song is? An echo song is when one person sings part of the song and the next person or group repeats after that person. So we are going to sing an echo story song today, Going on a Bear Hunt. So in the beginning of the song, we will start slowly, but at the end of the song, we will need to go very, very presto. Are you ready to sing the song with me? We can't go on a bear hunt sitting down. Let's stand up. A big one. I'm not scared. Oh no, look at the tall grass. We can't go over it. We can't go under it. We have to go through it. Catch a big one. I'm not scared. Oh no, look, it is a big river. We can't go over it. We can't go under it. We have to go through it. A big one. I'm not scared. Oh, yuck! Ugly, muddy mud. We can't go over it. We can't go under it. We have to go through it. Splash, 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 splash. We're going on a bear. We're gonna catch a big one. I'm not scared. What is that? It's a big, giant cave. We can't go over it. We can't go under it. We have to go through it. Oh no, I feel big. ears. I feel a big wet nose. I see sharp teeth. Oh no, it's a bear! Run! We need to run out of the cave. Step, 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 and through the mud. Squish, 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 over the river. Splash, 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 through the grass. Swish, 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 and into the house. Hurry and shut the door. We are safe for now. That was such a fun song. Thank you for singing it with me. Very good job using the tempo to tell a story for our song. Very good. You know, our class song is like a story song too. Let's think of the words for a few minutes today. Have you ever played outside in the rain? What kinds of things can you do in the rain? We can wear a raincoat and a rain hat. We can jump in the puddles. Do you remember the story in our song? The kids were all outside and it started to rain. Do you remember the Nepali words that we learned for the story in our song? Good! Pani Baryo. Can you say it? Pani Baryo. Very good! Pani Baryo means it's raining. Very good! So that is how our story in our song starts. It is raining. Do you remember what the kids were doing in the rain? They were listening! Very good! In Nepali, we say, Sun Dai Chu. Can you say it? Good! Very good! They were listening to the rain. Sun Dai Chu. Good job! What happened next in our story? Good, they heard the rain. Drip, drop, drip, drop. Do you think that the rain sounded loud or forte or soft and quiet? Very good. Maybe it was forte. Or maybe it was piano. Do you remember what the sound that the rain made? Tup, 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 tup. Very good. In Nepali, they say, Pani Parcha, tup, tup. It means the rain sounds like tup, tup. Can you say that with me? Pani Parcha. Very good. What happened next? Right, they were playing outside in the rain and listening to the rain go tup, 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 tup. And then they became soaking wet. They got all soaked. Bidekotu. Can you say that? Bidekotu. Very good. Bidekotu. Great job! Okay, let's try saying all of these words together. We will say the whole story of our song all together. Ready? Pani Baryo. Pani Baryo. Sun Dai Chu. Sun Dai Chu. Pani Barcha Tap Tap. Pani Barcha Tap. Bidekotu. Bidekotu. Very good. So you see, our song, our class song, also tells a story. Good job. People use many different instruments to tell stories in music. One common instrument that is used to tell a story by changing the tempo is the drum set. Today we have a very special guest with us. You see him often at your school. You know him well as Mr. Brock. Today, we are going to get to know him as Mr. Brock, the percussionist. Take a look.
Mr. Brock here. Welcome to the lab, as I call it. These are one of my drum sets, probably my favorite drum set because of my dad, and I still play them. I am not only what you know me to be at the school building. I'm also a musician, a percussionist, because the instrument that I play, which are the drums, belongs to the percussion band. So it's any instrument that allows me to play and make a sound with either your hand or sticks, in this case, my drum set. The drum set itself is actually a collection of percussion instruments that are played together by one musician. I'm going to introduce you step by step, one by one, to each member of my drum kit. Most of my drum kits actually are made up of four drums, and usually two or three cymbals, and what we call a hi-hat. I'll introduce you to each one. The drums that you hear most usually are the drum that you probably see on the floor, which is called the bass drum. Has the deepest sound of all of the drums that are here. And I play that with a pedal, where I step on the pedal like I would if I was driving a car, and it makes the drum beater of the pedal hit against the drum and make a sound like this. Now, the second, probably the most popular drum, the companion drum that goes along with the drum you just heard, is the snare drum, which is the drum that's closest to me. And the drum has what they call snares, or wires on the bottom of it, that make the drum sound a little different when the snares are attached to the bottom of the drum. So what that drum sounds like, now, when I play them together, because the beautiful thing about being a musician and definitely a drummer is you can create a conversation with the instruments that you play. So I can have my bass drum and my snare drum have a conversation. Now, the drum above it is what they call a tom drum. I did that and I wanted to have a conversation with these three drums. I can. Now, if I want to add a deeper tone, I would add the what we call the floor tom tom, which actually is called that because it's supported by legs and it's on the floor. And it has a deeper sound than the tom-tom that's mounted to my bass drum. So now I can have a conversation with just these two drums, which I've done, you know, in my drumming, or I can actually have a conversation with all four drums, which sounds like this. And the good thing about playing drums is I can always change the sound or the tones you hear by how loud I play, and better, how softly I play. Because the softer I play, the more tones I get to hear, not from what I'm just playing, but from what the other musicians are playing. Now, these are my two cymbals. One is larger than the other. This cymbal is called my ride cymbal. It's the cymbal that I want to play when I'm not playing the hi-hat, but I would play sort of the same rhythms I would play there. So now that means the hi-hat turns into something that's keeping time. So my hi-hat right now, if I keep it as a metronome, it's telling me that everything that I play on the drums and this cymbal, it should stay in that time. Let's see if I can actually do it. I'm a little rusty. Whenever I want to make a statement, kind of like if you were making a sentence, and instead of actually ending my sentence with a period, if I wanted to end it with an exclamation point, that's what this symbol is for. It's called a crash. And when I hit it, you'll know why it's called a crash. So let me see if I can play that rhythm again and then incorporate the crash symbol to let you know that, well, there was something that I was saying that I wanted you to pay attention to, because that's what this symbol is for. Is the drum set. It's my drum set. And as somebody who is in love with music, the more I find out about music, the more I realize how much I love the fact that music was part of my life. It allows for me to be creative in ways that I can use, not just in the music studio when I'm recording or when I'm playing outside for people to enjoy listening to music and it allows me to understand how music lives in my math lessons, the math lessons that I create. So we're talking about fractions sometimes, we're talking about whole, we're talking about parts, we're talking about how to multiply time, you know, instead of getting started to divide time. So being a musician actually is more than just being somebody who's musical, it's also being that. And being able to communicate, which I do. So, if I can help you become a musician, I definitely will do so. Some excitement.
I had so much fun with you all today. We really got to explore so many different elements of music. I hope you all have a fantastic week. And don't forget to do the other part of this assignment. I'll see you again next week. Goodbye.